We're on Jazz Street with Elizabeth Shepherd. Elizabeth, welcome to Rochester.
Thank you.
And the new album, Rewind, as well as also, of course, with the universe of John Lennon. Elizabeth, talk about how you came to jazz and how you discovered it and why you chose this field.
I came to jazz kind of late, actually. I grew up in the Salvation Army, so my parents were both Salvation Army ministers.
Really?
Yeah, so I grew up with a lot of Salvation Army music, which is not exactly jazz. It was that and classical music, because I was studying classical piano. And so I only really came to jazz, I guess it was in my 20s. I was at McGill University in Montreal at the time studying classical piano. And I was actually getting really into hip-hop. And I would listen to the samples and go, like, what is that? That is amazing. You know, and this is back in the heyday, like Tribe Called Quest and De La Soul and like some really quality stuff.
Mid-90s stuff.
Yeah, exactly. And so that's kind of what led me to jazz, the 70s stuff, you know, Freddie Hubbard and Herbie Hancock and the Headhunters. And I kind of worked backwards from there. And I think I came to it late because jazz, it's a really sophisticated form of music that I think, for me at least, I need to have some kind of solid grasp of music in general before I could really sink my teeth into it and appreciate it. And then I was hooked. I mean, I loved the freedom that that comes with jazz music, coming from the classical tradition and from a church tradition. It's about so many other aspects than just what's on the page.
Elizabeth, that said, with your album Rewind, just your approach of making really classic jazz standards, but really with a whole new twist and spin on it. So how did you come to arrange those great tunes, like especially Sack of Woe and other tunes like that? I just think it's so cool that you just took tunes we knew backwards and forwards, and all of a sudden hearing you do it, it's like we're hearing them all over again for the first time.
Well, I think part of it was not super conscious. I mean, I of course no one wants to do something that's been done already. That said, because I came to jazz pretty late, I didn't grow up sort of steeped in this tradition with these really set ideas of how these songs should sound or did sound, you know, according to so and so. And so I felt a certain freedom. Like some of the songs I just would actually read on the page, and you know, when you can read music, of course you can hear how this goes, and that was sort of my starting point. It wasn't a reference to someone else's version, it was a reference to the piece itself and going, oh, that's great, these lyrics or this melody or how that fits with the harmony, and hearing it in my head first and then sort of internalizing it and coming up with something at the piano. So it wasn't like I had someone's version in mind and then I was like, I'm going to get as far away from that as possible. It was just, how does this song strike me? How does it resonate with me and bring that out?
Very cool. And with tonight playing at the Montage with the universe of John Lennon, talk about, here's an icon in music, and yet a new twist and a new turn for a lot of folks from the jazz who really may not be, surprisingly, not familiar with John Lennon's music. So talk about making that bridge happen.
Well, I am one of those people who wasn't super familiar with his music, I gotta say. Like, I was really into the Beatles when I was 16, 17. Again, came to it late because I grew up in this bubble. But not so much John Lennon stuff. It was really Paul McCartney's voice that I was drawn to. And I was asked by Michael Occhipinti, who is the spearhead, who spearheads this project, if I would be part of it. And he took all these Lennon tunes and arranged them and rearranged them and twisted them and like put them out the other end with something totally different, his own stamp, really, really unique sounding. And I think I have a much deeper appreciation of John Lennon's music now that I've had the chance to sort of explore it through a completely different lens. And this is the beauty, I think, of having other musicians sometimes cover someone else's body of work. Because if you can't get past, like, I don't like Lennon's voice. I never could. And so if I couldn't get past that, it's great to have someone else present it to you, like, well, listen to it this way, you know, and he's brilliant.
Elizabeth, that said, talk about your life in the bubble in terms of you grew up in a Salvation Army household and that culture and then coming to jazz. Talk about the biggest similarities and differences of those two worlds.
Well, it's hard to say. I don't want to make any like blanket statements about what, for me, yeah. I mean, I guess what, growing up in the army, music was always really deeply linked to God and spirituality, and it was all about a form of praise and worship. And I've sort of I've left the church, but I haven't left, you know, my center and my roots. No, exactly. And so for me, jazz is sort of a way of further exploring that. It's really a, it's a spiritual thing for me. And it's enabled me to find some peace and some way of communicating with other people and with the divine. And like, it's really, I feel like it's the next place that I had to go, really.
You can see it twice, 6 and 10 o'clock tonight at the Montage. Elizabeth Shepherd, thanks so much for joining us, and we love your music so much.
Thank you.